I'm here with another gentle yoga practice for you today. A little bit of gentle movement, some mobility work for the joints, some balance work, a little bit of core thrown in for good measure. So we'll definitely work the whole body, but in a little bit more of a gentle way. You don't necessarily need any props today, unless you would like to maybe have a yoga block handy to help you reach the floor. So we're going to start lying down on our backs
and have the knees in and rock a little bit. That's always my favorite way to start once I come down to my back. Getting in touch with the breath. All right, from here we're going to start by waking up the ankle joints by making circles. And just do a few in both directions. I always find it interesting that some people move, you know, both feet in one direction or go in opposite. That's got to mean something. I don't know what, but I just find it interesting. From here, we're going to move up the leg and take the origination of the movement from the knee joint by circling the shins. Switch directions. And then we'll take it up to the hip joint. So think of your knees pulling in towards your chest a little bit more, opening wide, pushing forward back together. Both directions. Okay. From here, take feet to the mat. Bring the soles of the feet together. Let the knees drop open wide. And we're going to find cactus arms from here. All right, we're not going to stay here for too long. We're going to do a little bit of movement from this position. So I'm gonna roll over to my left side, trying to mostly stack my legs and stack my arms, and heads turn in that direction. And then I'm gonna keep my legs where they are, lift the top arm, roll back, let the head turn with, and then come back down over to that side. Back and forth. And you may not go all the way over, quote unquote, and you may find that your legs don't want to stay 100% still, and that's okay, right? Let's do one more. And then we'll stay in that open position. I'm going to lift the top leg and let it fall open. And then I'm gonna switch legs over to the other side, rolling everything over. And then again, I'll try to keep the legs there as I move the upper body back and forth into some twisting. And just like anything else, you may find some differences from side to side. This one feels a little bit more open for me. And sometimes that has as much to do with the shoulder as anything else. Okay, I'm going to stay open for a bit. And then lift the top leg. Let that fall back open. And then I'm going to keep doing that from side to side with the legs, keeping the upper body open. Lifting one leg, letting it fall. Lifting the opposite leg, letting it fall over. Up and open. Up and closed. Back and forth a few times. Next time I get to the open position with both knees out, I'm going to pause there, making the adjustments to make sure that you feel like things are placed comfortably. And then we're going to do a little bit of open and shut with everything. So as we inhale, lying here with arms open, maybe you get a little bit more lifted in your back, right? Sort of cat-cow-like, we'll take this. As we exhale, we're going to really press the low back down, lift both knees and arms and press them together. Inhale, open. Exhale, close. Squeeze. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Let's do one more. Inhale. And exhale. Lift the knees, hug them in, rock a little bit.
And from here,
let's rock all the way up.
And we'll transition onto hands and knees. All right, so we just did a little bit of cat-cow-like movement on our backs. We're gonna do a little bit here as well. We're gonna see if we can focus on just the pelvis, the lower back. And you can do whatever you want with your feet. It doesn't necessarily matter. But let's see if we can keep the middle to upper back a little bit more neutral and still as we tilt the pelvis back and forth. And it's pretty hard to do, just really isolating, because other stuff wants to get involved. So we're just doing our best, right? Area of the spine a little bit more neutral. We're going to do some movement a little bit higher up the spine to focus on some shoulder blade mobility. Right, so as we inhale, we're going to squeeze the shoulder blades together and let the chest kind of drop. And then as we exhale, we're going to kind of dome the upper back a little bit and let the shoulder blades spread. Right, they're retracting and protracting. Arms stay straight the whole time. See if you can feel how the shoulder blades glide. The arms are getting a little bit of work too, right? Okay, from here we're going to bring the right foot forward for a low lunge. And it doesn't need to be like a super deep lunge. Let's come up right from here. Take the right hand to the left shoulder. And then cross in front, left hand to right shoulder. Give your legs a little bit of a hug towards each other so that you can feel a little bit more stable. And we're gonna try some circling with the upper body from here. So taking the elbows down a bit and rounding, and then start to go up in one direction in a circle. Noticing balance is a little bit challenged, right? Switch directions. Okay, and then from upright, I'm gonna take the back of the right hand inside the right leg, reach the left arm up toward the ceiling, and I'm gonna try to kind of slide that hand down inside a bit as I bend over to the right, reaching that left arm over more, feeling all kinds of yummy stuff down the left side. Okay, and then I'm gonna take left hand to the mat and reach right arm up toward the ceiling for a twist. Take the hand down. Let's let the hips sink a little bit lower, and then we'll walk them back. Keeping toes down. If you want to breathe with it, inhale. And exhale. We'll do a few more. Keep your toes down for some. On some of them, let's flex and lift. Okay. forward for that lunge position. All right, we'll come upright, get our bearings, think of the legs kind of hugging in towards each other, make sure that things feel really rooted down. And I'll take left hand to right shoulder, right hand to left shoulder out in front. Give a little squeeze, and then we'll draw down,
rounding, and circle up to one side and back around. See if you can engage the legs a little bit more to stabilize. Switch directions.
Position, back of the left hand inside that left leg, right arm reaches up. I'm going to slide the left hand down as I side bend to the left and feel all kinds of stuff on that right side. And right hand comes down to the mat. Left arm reaches up for a twist. All right, let's take that hand down and we'll let the hips get a little lower, a little lungier, and then we'll walk it back and straighten back and forth. You can inhale forward, exhale back, or do it the other way, see what happens. And again, we're keeping toes down some of the time to feel top of the foot stretch, some of the time flexing to get a little bit more back of the leg. Okay, so from here, we're going to take this other leg back and lower down to our bellies. And from here, place your hands beside your chest, or maybe even a little further back if that feels okay. And we're going to start by just looking straight down at the mat to lengthen the neck as we roll the shoulders up and back a few times. Try to keep elbows a little closer by your sides. Switch directions. Feels a little bit weird to go forward for me. And then let's take them up and back one more time and keep them there. Keep your neck long. Squeeze your glutes a little bit. Big inhale. Exhale, lift the chest. Inhale, lower down. Exhale, lift. Inhale, lower. And exhale, lift. Lift from that lifted place. Let's bring one elbow forward and one elbow forward for six pose. Back is nice and warmed up now. All right, I love to do a little bit of neck movement in Sphinx pose because you can feel some really nice stretching through those upper traps. All right, so let's bring chin down toward the chest. And then as we lift up, think of the back of your head lifting, and you're trying to pull your ears back toward the shoulders. And you can look up if that feels okay. Feel some stretching in the throat. And then we'll take chin back down and try that a few times. And then if you want to kind of freestyle some neck movement here, side to side, etc., go for it. Okay. Let's lower all the way down. Wiggle the hips a little bit. Let's take it in a child pose from here. I'm going to do knees wide, You can adjust your legs however feels best for you. You could prop something behind your knees if you felt like that felt better as well. You could even have something down for your head.
Let's take a few breaths here and let our backs settle after that back bending work.
Do a little bit of movement and mobilization for the shoulders from this position.
So from here, I'm going to reach my arms all the way forward with the elbows lifted, and I'm going to keep my head down the whole time. I'll start with the left arm since it's closest to the camera. I'm going to lift that arm up and move it out to the left. Palm faces down here. When it's out to that side, I'm going to rotate it internally so the thumb starts to go down toward the floor and the palm starts to go up toward the ceiling. From there, I'm going to start to reach my arm further back, bending the elbow, reaching that hand behind my back. And I'm just going to let it hover so it stays active. And then I'm going to reach it back out from whence it came, rotating back to palm down when it's by the side, and then take it back forward and switch to the other arm. Lifting, reaching it out to the side, rotating thumb down, palm turns up. Start to reach it back and bend the elbow, letting the hand kind of hover above my back. Reaching back out, rotating palm back down, reaching forward, taking that hand down. Let's do one more on each side. Lift, reach to the side, rotate, reach back, elbow bends, hand hovers above the back, reach back out, rotate back forward and down, switching, reach up, out, rotate, bend and reach back, hover, reach back out, rotate back down, take it forward, hand down, let the elbows down, let the shoulders rest.
And from here, we're going to take it up into downward facing dog. Bring your knees more in line with your hips if they were wide. Plant the hands about shoulder width, maybe a little wider, and we'll tuck the toes, lifting knees and hips. Feet about hip width. From here, come way up on the tippy toes, inhale. Exhale, bend one knee and press down through the opposite heel. Maybe even lift those toes. Inhale, back up. Exhale, switch to the other side. Back and forth. Inhale. Exhale. One more each side. And then settling into down dog and maybe wiggling a little bit. And then we'll walk the feet up near the hands toward the top of the mat, feet about hip width, and just hang for a little bit. Knees can bend, you might grab elbows and sway a little bit. And from here, we'll carefully come on up to standing. Taking a moment. Mountain pose. All right, so we're gonna do a little bit of cat-cow-like movement with some shoulder mobility, doing some circles with the arms. So from here, I'm going to start with the arms forward. So I'm going to reach them up circularly, is that a word, and sort of get arched. And as they come back behind me, I'm going to round my back and tip my chin, arms reaching forward. As they go up, I'll go back toward cow. Exhale, rounding. Inhale. Try not to overthink it, right? Just moving and grooving.
directions. And then ending in mountain pose with a more neutral spine. Okay, so from here, I'm gonna put hands on hips and I'm gonna come up to the ball of my left foot. Make sure the right leg is well engaged and the left knee is bent. And I'm gonna spin on the ball of that foot. So the knee goes out and the knee goes in. This one always makes me think of the movie Grease. The very end when Sandy comes out in her get up, right? You know what I'm talking about? Stud. From that knee out position, let's take the foot a little closer in and maybe it comes up for a tree pose variation. Come up to the ball of the right foot and we'll spin on the ball of the foot. Open and shut with the knee, turning it out, turning it in. From the out position, inch it a little closer, maybe it can slide up and land for a tree pose. Take both arms up toward the ceiling. Grab hold of the left wrist. Give a tug to the right for a side bend. And then from that side bend position, we're going to see if we can kind of rotate over to the left and back forward a few times. And I'm trying to mostly move the upper body. The hips want to come too. Okay, come back up. Grab the right wrist, tug to the left. And then from there, trying to rotate a bit up and to the right and back forward. Okay, come back up and release the arms. From here, I'm gonna take a step back to find warrior one. Stepping the left foot back, right? And it lands at about a 45 degree angle, a little over to the left. And we'll bend the right knee to come into that. Arms reach up from here. And then we're gonna think back to when we were in a low lunge and recreate our side bend here. So I'm gonna take the right hand down inside that right leg. And I'm gonna kind of slide it down as I bend over toward the right. Keep pushing into the back foot. All right, I'm gonna come back up, reach both arms up, and then make cactus arm position from here. Try to keep lower body somewhat fixed, and we'll twist the upper body from side to side a few times. Seeing that it's a lot easier to turn open to the left than it is to go to the right. Okay, we'll face forward with those cactus arms, trying to keep the elbows about straight out from the shoulders. We'll rotate hands down and back up a few times. Doing the robot. But we'll feel this in the shoulders. Okay, and we'll go back up. Reach the hands out, we'll rotate. Internally, thumbs down, palms back. Reach back and find a hand clasp. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold, humble warrior. Working in the direction of folding inside the thigh. Release the hands down. Let's step the left foot forward.
forward, we'll take another easy fold. Hang for a little bit. And we'll carefully come on up. And we'll do that warrior one step on the other side. Taking a step back with the right foot, a little to the right. Right about 45 degrees with the foot. All right, bending the left knee, reaching arms up. And then we'll take back of the left hand down inside that left leg, and it slides down a bit as we bend to the left, reaching that right arm over, feeling some stuff on the right side, pressing the right foot firmly down. And we'll come on back up. Left arm reaches up. Finding our cactus arms and doing this twist, trying to just move the upper body best we can feel, right? Observing the difference between an open twist and a closed twist. Okay, and then we'll face forward with cactus arms and do our rotating down to feel that stuff in the shoulders one more time. Last one. Okay, and then we'll extend from the elbows, internally rotate, thumbs down, palms back, reach back and interlace. Inhale, lift. Exhale, fold. Humble warrior. Breathe. Take the hands down. Let's step the right foot up next to the left for another easy fold. We'll take a moment here. And then this time from this fold, I'm going to take my hands forward a little bit, and you could absolutely have something to reach for, whatever you got in your house, be it a basket or furniture, an ottoman, what have you, right? And we're going to work the feet a little bit here in this fold. Make sure your feet are about hip width. We're going to come up to tippy toes and then drop the heels and rock back until you're just on the heels, back and forth. Inhale. Inhale, exhale. One around. All right, from here we're going to come down to seated.
Any way you need to.
Reach your legs forward. Find your sitting bones and sit up nice and tall. And we're going to just inch it forward into a forward fold from here, flexing the feet, trying to stay a little bit more neutral through the spine, a little bit, straighter, not too extended, not too rounded, somewhere in the middle. Here, I'm going to turn sideways on my mat, and you might just sort of space your legs a little bit wider, but we're going to have the knees bent, so whatever helps you to figure out how you need to do that, right? Hands can come behind you. We're going to windshield wiper legs from side to side a few times. A little hip mobility exercise. So as we go to the right, we're externally rotating right hip, internally rotating left hip, and vice versa. And eventually we'll take that into a more held position. We'll see what we feel. Last round. And then I'm going to drop mine over to the right. and adjust the legs so that they are at 90 degree angles. If you need to move to make sure that you have a little more padding for your knees, do that. And then from here, I'm going to try to square a little bit more toward that front leg, and then just start to reach forward and fold to whatever point I feel comfortable going. I've got my right elbow down so I can feel a little bit more restful here. And we should be feeling a little bit of something in that right hip, right? There, and I'm going to switch that rotation over to the other side, checking in to make sure I have found 90 degree angles approximately with both legs, and I'll square toward that front leg and find my fold. And I'm feeling something slightly interesting. Pretty nice little hip stretch there on the left side. This may be a nice alternative for you to the more traditional pose of pigeon, which we do in a lot of yoga classes. This one is, you know, definitely in that same ballpark, but a lot friendlier on the knees. So you can file that away if this feels okay for you. Okay, gonna lift back up, and I'm gonna come a little bit more toward the top of the mat. Again, facing forward, knees bent, feet down on the mat. Gonna do just a little bit of core work here to get us back down to our mats by rolling down, and this can kind of feel a little cat-cow-like, right? Exhale, round down, and your core's got to hold you up. Inhale, lift back up, and maybe you want to extend a little bit. Exhale, inhale. And you can decide how far down you want to go, right? Maybe go a little lower each time. Coming up's the hard part though. One more. And we'll stay down. And we'll hug the knees again. And rock a little bit. End with a nice happy baby from here. I like to grab big toes because that helps me keep the shoulders a little bit more relaxed and the low back all the way down, right? If I try to grab my feet, my low back lifts, right? So maybe grab something else. You could even grab your ankles, right? And we'll just take a moment here and rock. And breathe and settle. Let's release those legs down and have a little rest in Shavasana. Close your eyes, turn your palms up. Let everything go, let your breath be natural, and let yourself rest.
Gently begin to wiggle fingers and toes, deepening your breath. Circle wrists and ankles a few times. From here, let's reach the arms up toward the ceiling and press through the hands. And then we'll take fingers up and down a few times, flexing and extending the wrists. Arms overhead and stretch along through fingertips, through toes. Hug the knees one last time and rock. And then roll over to your side and rest there. Pressing up gently to a comfortable seat. Close your eyes and bring your hands together at your heart. Take a moment to observe, notice how things are feeling. Take a moment to acknowledge the efforts that you put forth in your practice. Thank you so much for joining me. I look forward to practicing with you again soon. Namaste.